Hi guys, you're welcome back to my channel. It's your next door nurse Florence, and on this channel we'll talk all about emergency preparedness, health and wellness tips. In today's video, we're going to be discussing how to assess and manage wound exudates at home. Let's get started. Exudate is a fluid that oozes out from tissue through small blood vessels into a wound or inflamed area. It contains a variety of components such as water, electrolytes, proteins, and cells, depending on the specific condition of the wound or inflammation. It can vary in color, consistency, and odor. Exudate plays a crucial role in the body's natural healing process as it helps to clean the wound or inflamed area, delivers immune cells to the site of injury or infection, and provides the necessary nutrients and growth factors for tissue repair. However, excessive or abnormal exudate production can sometimes indicate an underlying health issue or impaired wound healing. There are five main types of exudates. Each type provides valuable information about the wound healing process, and they are classified based on their composition and appearance. 1. Serous exudate. This type of exudate is clear and watery, similar to the fluid found in blisters. It mainly contains water, electrolytes, and small amounts of protein. 2. Sanguineous exudate. This exudate is red and contains a large amount of red blood cells, indicating significant bleeding or hemorrhage in the wound. 3. Serous sanguineous exudate. This exudate contains a combination of both serous and sanguineous components. It is typically light pink or light red in color and has a watery consistency with small amount of blood mixed in. 4. Purulent exudate. This is commonly known as pus. It is thick and contains a high concentration of white blood cells, dead bacteria, and tissue debris. It typically indicates an infection. 5. Fibrinous exudate. This type of exudate is thick and sticky, composed of large molecules such as fibrinogen and fibrin. It is commonly found in conditions such as pleurisy and pericarditis. Assessing wound exudates at home is an important skill for individuals who are caring for their own wounds or for those providing wound care to family members. While it is essential to seek professional medical care for complex or severe wounds, being able to recognize changes in exudates can help individuals identify potential issues and seek medical attention when necessary. To assess wound exudates at home, follow these steps. 1. Visual examination. Begin by carefully inspecting the wound and the exudate. Note the color, consistency, and amount of the fluid. Serous exudate is clear and watery. Sanguineous exudate is bloody. Serous sanguineous exudate is a mixture of clear and bloody fluid. And purulent exudate is thick, opaque, and yellow or green in color. 2. Odor assessment. Take note of any unusual smells coming from the wound. Foul-smelling exudates may indicate the presence of infection. 3. Measurement. Assess the amount of exudate produced by the wound. This can be done by placing a clean gauze over the wound and observing the saturation, or by using a scoring system if available. 4. Documentation. Keep track of your observation in a journal or a chart. Record the color, consistency, odor, and amount of the exudate, as well as any changes that occur over time. After conducting an assessment at home, and if it is determined that the exudate does not require immediate medical attention, there are several steps that can be taken to manage the exudate. 1. Keep the wound or the affected area clean. Gently clean the area with mild soap and water, and pat it dry with a clean towel. Do not apply any harsh chemicals or strong detergents to the area. 2. Apply a sterile dressing. If the exudate is coming from a wound, cover the wound with a sterile dressing or bandage to help absorb the exudate and protect the area from further contamination. 3. Elevate the affected area. If the exudate is coming from an extremity, such as a leg or arm, elevate the affected area to help reduce swelling and promote drainage of the exudate. 4. Monitor for signs of infection. Keep an eye on the exudate for any changes in color, odor, consistency, as these could be signs of infection. If you notice any concerning changes, seek medical attention. 5. Stay hydrated and eat a healthy diet. Proper nutrition and hydration are important for the body's healing process. So be sure to drink plenty of water and eat a well-balanced diet rich in nutrients. It is important to remember that these steps are general guidelines and may not be appropriate for all cases of exudate. If you have any concerns about the exudate, or if it is not improving with at-home care, it is essential to seek medical advice from a healthcare professional. Always follow the professional advice of a healthcare professional when managing exudates at home. So guys, we've come to the end of today's topic on how to manage and assess wound exudates at home. If you found it helpful and useful, please give me a thumbs up by clicking on the like button. Subscribe to my channel for free by clicking on the red subscribe button. Turn on the notification bell so you'll be the first to know when I upload new videos. You can send your comments, questions in the comment section and I will attend to them. I remain your next door nurse and I'm just a knock away. I love you guys. I'll see you in my next video.